بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله. Welcome viewers to my channel Spread the Light. In my previous video I discussed about the definitions and basic types of knowledge management and knowledge workers. In today's video I shall explain the infrastructure required for knowledge management. As we all know that the system and services may not always enhance knowledge management. In order to be effective, they must also be aligned to a certain infrastructure which encourages sharing and focusing of efforts on the core business. Infrastructure is the backbone of any system or process, so the significant efforts should be contributed towards the development of a sound and effective infrastructure, especially in the case of knowledge management. This session is comprised of 6 segments under the headings of number 1 managerial infrastructure, technical technological infrastructure, number 3 social infrastructure, number 4 harnessing organizational knowledge, number 5 enabling knowledge transferences, and in the end I will summarize some important topics of this session. The creation of organizational knowledge relies on many systems and processes that make up the organizational infrastructure. 3 types of infrastructure operate in most of the organization: managerial, technological, and social infrastructure. First, I will address the managerial infrastructure. Managerial support for knowledge workers and the formal management process in the organization significantly affect the knowledge management outcomes. Ideally, the managerial infrastructure provides a supportive framework for resourcing, decision-making, and innovative practices so that knowledge activities can be successfully pursued. Management provides the resourcing and support to ensure that desired goals are achieved. In knowledge-intensive community, the managers generally operate with knowledge workers as both as a facilitator and a partner, rather than as a controller of the task and activities. Knowledge workers expect significant autonomy and trust from their managers, who should operate as supportive agents, providing guidance, feedback, and resources to achieve the necessary outcomes. Successful knowledge management requires an open management style, which encourages sharing across the organization. As a macro level, the way the organization supports its knowledge workers through its employment policies and practices also affect the knowledge workers' capacity to pursue the desired knowledge activities. Human resource management handles the recruitment, retention, development, and nurturing of staff in the organization. The HRM process seeks to ensure that the best people are employed, that they are well supported throughout their careers in the company, and that they are strongly motivated to remain with the firm. HRM focuses on developing the best employee support system and rewards to achieve maximum organizational benefit. Its key purpose is to align the people process with the corporate priorities so that each person strives to achieve the company's goal. In a knowledge-intensive community, there will normally be a greater emphasis on providing support for development, growth, and the ongoing development of knowledge-related capabilities. An important aspect of the HRM service relates to helping the knowledge transfer across the organization through job rotation, temporary appointments, and other forms of exposure to practice in other units. Another form of infrastructure is technological infrastructure. The technological infrastructure provides the mechanism by which people can share, and transfer information and knowledge. These systems enable the recording, transmission, and extraction of data for different purposes. For example, the complementary data relating to human resource, financial, and customer information might each provide important insights into a customer's support issues. The ongoing exchange and modification of knowledge generates new and better approaches to problems and challenges. This process relies on flexible and responsive system so that the changing knowledge may be captured and maintained. Barriers can include systems that operate with different technical structures as well as restrictions on access that limit the use of system. A reluctance to allow widespread access to different knowledge sources often stems from a concern for the way the information will be used or belief that withheld knowledge equates to power. The technological infrastructure can be a key ingredient of a successful knowledge management strategy, or a major impedance depending on the organizational approach and knowledge policy. Technological infrastructure is further divided into two kinds of categories. First one is library and information services. Larger organizations identify their library and information services as key elements of their knowledge strategy. The shift from paper to electronic forms of information has changed the nature of the services offered to users. It has allowed a more responsive and accessible service to operate either centrally or from the desktop of the user. Effective library services should be connected with the users, monitoring their changing needs, profiles, and work priorities. They may also operate as central or decentralized services or as a combination of both approaches. Library services can in particular highlight knowledge which has been gained by external experts and help to build capable and informed knowledge users. Second category of technology infrastructure is record management. Firms generate enormous quantities of records that need to be managed. Core organizational data drawn from these sources need to be identified, cataloged, stored, so that they may be retrieved at need. In well-structured environment, there may be policies, staff assigned to records management functions, and clear guidelines on what should and should not be preserved. Records management basically complement knowledge management organizations. Records are important sources of learning. Many aspects of knowledge creation also become elements of future records. Technology and information systems are only a part of the information infrastructure needed for successful knowledge management. The next category of infrastructure is social infrastructure. I have discussed in my previous video about the significance of strategic knowledge management and emphasized the need to create a strong link between the process of capturing and sharing knowledge and strategic priorities of the organization. The social infrastructure helps this process by guiding and encouraging the social and professional interaction of the organization members with colleagues, clients, and other stakeholders. This infrastructure also offers insights into the knowledge contents, including the value and priorities which should operate. It helps to create meaning and identifies the purpose of activities undertaken. It also guides the understanding of members as to the priorities which are strategically important. A number of factors influence the social construction of organization. For example, there may be varying emphasis on collective or individual outcomes, competition or collaboration, long-term versus short-term priorities, external or internal relationship building, and tradition or innovation. Organizations which emphasize relationship building or long-term outcomes, collaboration and cooperation, and a focus on the corporate goal will be more capable of effectively managing knowledge. First, I will address the managerial infrastructure. Managerial support for knowledge workers and the formal management process in the organization significantly affect the knowledge management outcomes. Ideally, the managerial infrastructure provides a supportive framework for resourcing, decision-making, and innovative practices so that knowledge activities can be successfully pursued. Management provides the resourcing and support to ensure that desired goals are achieved. In knowledge-intensive communities, the managers generally operate with knowledge workers as both as a facilitator and a partner, rather than as a controller of the task and activities. Knowledge workers expect significant autonomy and trust from their managers, who should operate as supportive agents, providing guidance, feedback, and resources to achieve the necessary outcomes. Successful knowledge management requires an open management style, which encourages sharing across the organization. Next dimension of social infrastructure is to address the aspect of employees and knowledge environment. Employees influence and are influenced by their knowledge environment. It is important to ensure careful quality control of any documents before it is forwarded to a client. However, multi-level scrutiny sends a strong message that employees are not regarded as competent to manage their professional roles. The learning organization message, which encourages self-management and personal responsibility, may be contradicted by highly prominent risk aversion. In this situation, the employee will be reluctant to risk exposure of errors, and the learning focus will be ignored in favor of meeting company standards and requirements. Trust and relationship building underlies the knowledge processes and heavily influences the level to which effective knowledge management develops. Different knowledge approaches emerge in different knowledge communities. For example, an organization aiming to create uniformity and regulated practice is likely to place great importance on codifying and disseminating existing good practice. We can take the example of banks, where the well-defined tasks are assigned to specific bankers, like achieving deposit targets or customer dealing or cash deposits, etc. These all functions are already codified and well explained. Thus, there is more emphasis on knowledge adoption than on innovation in this setting. On the other hand, personalized knowledge, which requires inventive, analytical, creative, and reflective process, is better suited to flexible work environment, where many of the business problems are unique and changeable. In this case, those with established expertise and knowledge of the broader work content provide better support to the organization, particularly in terms of their capacity to share their knowledge with others. Thus, knowledge culture may be strongly influenced by the type of the employees present and the kind of the work done. Third dimension of social infrastructure deals with other stakeholders. A knowledge-intensive community includes a number of other stakeholders who contribute to the knowledge process. Customers play an important role in any business in that they are the recipients of the work product and sometimes the proposers of knowledge problems or products. Customers may be internal staff or external clients. Awareness of both external and internal customer is important in a knowledge management environment because knowledge outcomes need to be strategically valuable and acceptable to those who will ultimately benefit. Commercial organization must operate with the stakeholders in mind. An effective relationship needs to be built with these stakeholders so that they negotiate and recognize the value of the knowledge strategy as a long-term significant economic and social initiative. Effective measurement of knowledge and intellectual capital can be one way of regenerating this support and commitment. Business networks and partnerships are becoming more common as the capacity to share and interact expands. Many companies value the opportunity to explore ideas and to identify and copy good practices from external colleagues and partners. The development of collaborative relationships takes time and efforts to establish and sustain. It also operates with the expectation that the interchange of ideas will be beneficial to both parties and relatively equitable. This collaborative exchange is a further example of the way in which knowledge operates as a mechanism for ongoing learning and improvement. Organizations do not operate in a vacuum. They are evolving entities that are shaped by internal and external influences and which reflect the differing beliefs and values, which are put forward as corporate values and shared throughout the knowledge community. After the analysis of knowledge management infrastructure, there is another aspect of harnessing organizational knowledge. Each knowledge stream contributes to the development of corporate intellectual capital. Every staff member controls a range of knowledge contributors. Organizations face two major challenges in effectively using this knowledge: knowing what is known Another one is facilitating its capture and sharing. The knowledge core is the accumulated mass of strategic knowledge which is identified, publicly valued, captured, and disseminated by the organization. This core promotes the best information performance and ensures that the key strategic priorities are served. It clearly indicates what is valued in the organization and ensures the preservation of areas that are instrumental in maintaining organizational effectiveness. It can also facilitate better translation of tacit knowledge into actual practice, as the value of the identified knowledge is determined. The failure to clearly or sufficiently delineate corporate knowledge can lead to significant losses to the business, as employees may work towards non-strategic outcomes because it is not clear what knowledge should be learned and shared. It is of benefit to any firm to be aware of the current and ongoing growth in skills, knowledge, and capabilities of its employees. Regular audits of the staff potentials and current capabilities can be an important way of maximizing staff contribution. Enabling knowledge transferences is another very important factor after the development of knowledge management infrastructure. Every organization needs to be clear about its knowledge requirement, especially the intellectual capital areas that are essential to the core business. Recognition of mission-critical information assets enables assessment of the risk attached to losing them. The way knowledge is generated and transmitted within and throughout the organization can greatly influence its transferability. Many traditional organizations still rely on knowledge chains, reflecting their concerns for controlling and organizing knowledge. These rely on one-to-one exchange, often between supervisor and subordinate, to generate an understanding of how knowledge is being used and the way work is done. Although it can ensure standardized, reliable, and systematic practices, it reduces the potential for creative and flexible work responses. More effective coordination of various knowledge sources can operate through a central knowledge hub. These centralized agencies coordinate a range of knowledge sources and promote their use throughout the wider knowledge community. Library information services, centralized information technology services, and emerging knowledge services operate on these principles, acting as link between people, objects, and information avenues. These services provide support to knowledge creators and seekers and aim to avoid duplication and waste of resources. The effectiveness of the centralized services in effectively diffusing knowledge to the individual recipients determines knowledge management's overall success. The central agency may act as a gatekeeper, either limiting or encouraging access to business-related knowledge. Limited access will hinder knowledge diffusion. A more dispersed and beneficial knowledge environment operates as a knowledge web, where many members share their expertise with others. Each person may have a different network pattern, determined by his or her expertise, knowledge of others, and particular knowledge needs. This person may be a node for others, as an expert source of knowledge, while also using others as a node of information. Thus, each person in the web may act as both recipient and disseminator of knowledge, depending on the circumstances. This form of knowledge network is based on the development of effective connections with others and is open-ended and dynamic. This model enables more active and effective use of the various capabilities in the business environment. However, a major limitation of this model is that it relies on people finding and about expertise in order to access it. Over time, a number of explicit knowledge artifacts will be produced reflecting the final outcomes of the knowledge creation process. These are often called knowledge objects. Some typical knowledge objects might be interview guidelines, reports, data on organizational activities, technical specifications, training materials, and other forms of organizational outputs and inputs. These are important to the efficient operations of the business because they promote create practices through modeling and adoption rather than through reinvention. Knowledge objects are increasingly stored electronically on the internet for employees' access. However, when searching for relevant objects and guidelines, employees may encounter problems such as unwieldy structure of the repository, out-of-date items, duplicated or contradictory resources, inaccessible confidential materials, lost or withheld items, or an inconsistent approach to naming and codifying the objects. Careful consideration must be given to how these objects are managed and promoted to the contributors and users. Another issue relating the knowledge object is the question of ownership of intellectual property. This can be defined as the product of creative activities, which may be in the form of an idea, a publication, or some other physical representation. The original creator may claim ownership of their intellectual property because it was drawn from his or her intellectual activity. In many aspects of life, this is regarded as the rightful possession of the individual. A range of other issues relating to the corporate philosophy concerning knowledge and its codification and use may emerge, including the need to standardize or customize knowledge products. Standardization occurs when a regulated process is established so that each user follows the same system. For example, PowerPoint templates are a typical standardized product, enabling people to complete standard form, which may be entered into a database for access by other people as well. Customization occurs when a product or process is altered to better suit the particular need of the user. This reduces its universal application even though it enhances its relevance to that local user. For example, a database may require customization to include fields of information which are relevant to a particular operational unit, but which has no relevance to other areas. Now here we summarize the whole session as the knowledge management infrastructure of the organization is a complex interaction of systems, objects, embedded knowledge, and ongoing dynamic interchange. As such, it relies heavily on the building of good process throughout the enterprise, though organization of tasks and routines. The development of effective knowledge system will ensure effective knowledge management. Knowledge process encourages staff to learn and innovate, but firms need to encourage active, committed knowledge communities so that knowledge flows freely and creatively across any structured boundaries. This is the basic challenge for these seeking to develop effective knowledge management system. All right, viewers, now we have come to the end of this session, and at the end, as I have promised you to share any new quotation from any inspirational influential personality, here I took a quotation quote of Hazrat Ali al-Islam. He says, "The most complete gift of God is a life based on knowledge." It is a beautiful and thoughtful quotation, and I also request you to think about it and share it to others. Anyway, thank you so much, viewers. In my next video, I shall address the topic of 5 P's of strategic knowledge management and building knowledge management into strategic framework. I hope you have understood and learned a lot from today's video. If you have any ambiguity in any point, you can share and ask me question and write to me at this email address. I will definitely reply to the best of my knowledge. And in the end, I will request to share and subscribe my channel, spread the light, and share this video as much as possible so that other people can get also benefit from this knowledge. And thank you so much. Always stay blessed.